Mediaite has exclusively obtained more damning and potentially incriminating audio transcripts of Roger Stone, featuring Roger Stone. Now, last week on Friday, the same outlet, Mediaite, released a transcript of Roger Stone allegedly telling an NYPD officer, or I should say, basically telling an NYPD officer to abduct and punish a prosecutor involved in the Mueller investigation. But now this new audio that Mediaite has listened to and has provided transcripts of indicates that Stone has plotted for the murder of two Democratic lawmakers, specifically Jerry Nadler and Eric Swalwell, both Democratic congressmen in the House of Representatives. Now, in the new transcripts of the audio that were obtained and released by Mediaite, Stone tells his associate and former NYPD officer Sal Greco, quote, "It's time to do it. Let's go find Swalwell. It's time to do it. Then we'll see how brave the rest of them are. It's time to do it. It's either Nadler or Swalwell has to die before the election," meaning before the 2020 election. And he continues to say they need to get the message. Let's go find Swalwell and get this over with. I'm just not putting up with this crap anymore. Now, a source familiar with the discussion that Roger Stone had with Sal Greco, again, the former NYPD officer who was serving as security for Roger Stone, basically says to Mediaite that he or she believes that Stone was absolutely serious about what he was proposing here. It was definitely concerning that he was constantly planning violence with an NYPD officer and other militia groups. So what was the reasoning behind the threats? What motivated Roger Stone to want to go after, potentially violently, against Nadler and Swalwell? Well, apparently Stone had been at war with Nadler and Swalwell for years. He just hates them, according to the source. He just wanted to get Trump back into office so these things would stop. So both Nadler and Swalwell serve on the House Judiciary Committee. And at the time of this conversation that Roger Stone had, which by the way took place at Caffe Europa, Nadler had announced the committee would be investigating then Donald Trump's decision to commute Stone's sentence after he himself was convicted of federal crimes in special counsel Robert Mueller's Russia probe. So specifically, Roger Stone was convicted of obstruction, witness tampering, he was threatening witnesses, and also lying to Congress during the Mueller investigation. Prosecutors sought a 9-year prison sentence for the longtime Republican operative, but Trump's Justice Department reportedly intervened to impose a less severe sentence. Stone's sentence, though, was eventually commuted by Trump days before reporting to prison, so he didn't serve a single day behind bars. Now that decision by Trump was what the House Judiciary Committee was supposed to investigate, and apparently that got Roger Stone's dander up and led to him wanting to, according to what he said to this former NYPD officer, essentially murder Nadler and Swalwell as a result of what they wanted to investigate. Now, these comments were released after Mediaite's first article indicating that there were other audio clips that they listened to. In those audio clips, and they shared the transcripts of this, Stone was making similar threats toward prosecutor Aaron Zelensky. He said, quote, "He needs to be punished. You have to abduct him and punish him. That has to be done. It will be easy to abduct him because he is a weakling." And once again, Roger Stone blamed the comments on AI. So he is denying that he ever said any of this stuff. He claims that these are fake audio recordings created by artificial intelligence. And Stone told Mediaite regarding the Swalwell and Nadler statements, quote, "Total nonsense. I've never said anything of the kind. More AI manipulation. You asked me to respond to audios that you don't let me hear and you don't identify a source for. Absurd." However, interestingly enough, Mediaite reached out to the former NYPD officer, Sal Greco, and Greco did not deny the veracity of the audio. He did say this, though, "I don't think your reader is interested in ancient political fodder." I don't know, Sal. I think if someone was plotting to murder sitting members of Congress, law enforcement at least should be interested in learning more about that. So is this gonna be investigated? Because I totally think it should be. I mean, look, Roger Stone should want it investigated. He's claiming that this is artificial intelligence. So someone's completely, in his words, making up that Roger Stone has said these terrible, terrible things that are incredibly incriminating. So wouldn't he want the authorities to investigate it? I'm just looking out for Roger Stone. I really want to get to the bottom of the truth. I think they should investigate it. Because if it's untrue, then the public should know about it. And if it is true, I think it is unacceptable, to say the least, to have public figures like Roger Stone plotting for the murder of sitting members of Congress. How is that okay? So look, this story just broke. And I'm sure it's gonna develop, I'm sure we'll learn more about it. But I am very curious to see what the response is. Is this just another story that's gonna fall by the wayside and we're gonna pretend like it's not a serious issue? Or is it going to be investigated by the authorities? Because again, we're talking about a guy who was plotting the January 6th riots with the Proud Boys, Enrique Tarrio specifically. In fact, Donald Trump's connection to Enrique Tarrio, that link was Roger Stone. I mean, this guy gets in the middle of everything and causes so many problems. And so if he did in fact say these things, if he was in fact trying to persuade Greco to engage in the murder of sitting members of Congress, well then there should be consequences for that. And we should question whether or not there were any actions taken to fulfill that proposal. Now luckily, it doesn't appear that anything terrible has happened to Nadler and Swalwell, but it is unbelievable to me that that Roger Stone can just, if this is proven to be true, call for this kind of violence and for literally years get away with it. Because this conversation clearly happened in 2020, it didn't happen last week. And so now that we know about it, now that we have more details, let's see if there's gonna be any action taken to investigate this. I hope there will be, but we'll fill you in if we learn more about it.